Discuss Ashoka's Dhamma. Do you think that it was a scheme of social welfare? After the Kalinga War, the greatest ideas and objectives before Ashoka, the greatest Mauryan king, was the propagation of Dhamma. The Dhamma, as explained in Ashoka's edicts, is not a religion or a religious system, but a moral law, a common code of conduct, or an ethical order. In Pillar Edict 2, Ashoka himself put the question, "What is Dhamma?" Then he enumerates the two basic attributes of constituents of Dhamma, less evils as rage, cruelty, anger, pride, and envy are to be avoided, and many good deeds like kindness, liberality, truthfulness, gentleness, self-control, purity of heart, attachment of morality, inner and outer purity, etc., are to be pursued vigorously. Ashoka, in Rock Edict 12 and many other edicts, prescribes the following codes to be followed. Number 1. Obedience to mother and father, elders, teachers, and other respectable persons. Number 2. Respect towards teachers. Number 3. Proper treatment towards ascetics, relations, slaves, servants and dependents, the poor and miserable, friends and acquaintances and companions. Number 4. Liberality towards ascetics, friends, comrades, relatives and the aged. Number 5. Abstention from killing of living beings. Number 6. Non-injury to all living creatures. Number 7. Spending little and accumulating little wealth. Number 8. Mildness in case of all living creatures. Number 9. Truthfulness. Number 10. Attachment to morality. Number 11. Purity of heart. Thus, Ashoka tried to install moral law or Dhamma as the governing principle and forced in every sphere of life. Dhamma of Ashoka thus is a code for normal and virtuous life. He never discussed God or soul or religion as such. He asked people to have control over their passion, to cultivate purity of life and character in innermost all thoughts, to be tolerant to other religions, to abstain from killing or injuring animals, and to have regard for them, to be charitable to all, to be respectful to parents, teachers, relatives, friends, and ascetics, to treat slaves and servants kindly, and above all, to tell the truth. Ashoka not only preached but also practiced these principles. He gave up hunting and killing of animals. He established hospitals for men and animals and made liberal donations to the Brahmana and ascetics of different religious sects. He created rest houses, caused wells to be dug and trees to be planted along the roads. After the Kalinga War, he adopted Buddhism, one of whose cardinal doctrines was non-violence and non-injury to living beings. This also became the basis of Ashoka's Dhamma. Ashoka also took for the propagation of Buddhism. He conducted Dhamma Yatras and instructed his officials to do the same. He appointed social class of officials called Dhammatras, whose sole responsibility was to propagate Dhamma among the people. He could not be satisfied by the propagation of Dhamma in the Indian subcontinent only. He sent missions to foreign countries also to propagate Dhamma. His missionaries went to Western Asia, Africa, and Eastern Europe of the foreign kings, whose kingdom thus received the message of Buddhism. Five are mentioned in the inscriptions of Ashoka, namely Antiochus Theos of Syria and Western Asia, Ptolemy Philadelphus of Egypt, Antigonus Gonatas of Macedonia, Megas of Cyrene, and Alexander of Epirus. The king even sent his son Mahendra and daughter Sanghamitra to propagate Buddhism in Ceylon, that is Sri Lanka. So, it is proved that Ashoka and his Dhamma was influenced by Buddhism.
সংবাদ বা সাংবাদিকতা একবিংশ শতকে নানা প্রকারে সামনে আসে, যথা নাম্বার ওয়ান অনুসন্ধান।
For more updates, subscribe the channel and click the bell icon below this video.